super strong individual, and they were required to work together to strengthen that club. So you will notice a couple of things. I'm an unscripted speaker. That's either a good thing or a bad thing. I don't have cables in front of me, therefore you cannot gauge when I'm going to finish. Number two, I have a good command of English language, however I like using my pattern.
That's right.
I certainly hope that no one will be offended by the use of colloquial expression. I do make you sometimes when you speak your pattern, you make your point and just smile a little bit different.
That's right.
Is that okay with
that's
you?
Okay. Everyone. That's fine, girl.
I may not stand behind this lecture because I'm known to walk and dramatize, and I hope that is okay with you as well. Thank you so very much for accepting the invitation to me. I do apologize for coming in a bit late. Digital Rising Stars finals, they're tomorrow, so we have to prep for that today. And then, of course, later on, I have the St. George's Hall of Fame banquet, so I might not be here for the entire time. Where are my youth? The members of the newly formed, newly appointed youth club, police youth club, where are they? Are they here? Please stand. Please stand. Please stand. Your own, please stand. Is this everyone?
No.
Because we invited other people to stand throughout the proceedings, but these are the superstars. So again, clap yourselves and we invite you all. Thank you very much.
You know where my shop is.
Now we see the world soar, we see the world success, and a lot of people think that this is easy. We can do it. It is as simple as ABC, and I'm here to stand and I'm here to tell you that it isn't. The first thing we have to do is we have to figure out who we are. Before we can consider working as a group, before we can consider strengthening the core of the youth club, we need to figure out who we are. The faster, the quicker you identify who you are and accept who you are and love who you are, the better it is. Because a lot of us are 34, 44, 54, are still trying to figure out who we are. When I entered this Shamika world in 2005, I mean, I'm a tomboy. I just wore skirts and knees because I was coming here to see. But I am still very much a tomboy. And when I entered this Shamika world in 2005, I entered with a big afro. And I remember the very first time we had our public appearance at Summit Center, we did the whole parade. After all, I mean, people made a lot of noise for me. I didn't know them, but I was grateful. Grateful, right, Tina? Grateful. A lady came over to my mom and she said, oh my God, your daughter is so nice. Bubbly personality. She got the audience, but it's a pity she can't win. Or she said that to my mom. And my mother asked her, well, if you thought she's so great, why would you think that? And she said, well, you know, have you seen what Mr. in the world looks like? Because she's kind of black. And I do consider myself a black lady. I don't know, browning, lighting, wearing, I'm a black woman. Then she said, and come on up, the girls who were in the stream where they all have
long
hair. And she's standing there with a natural big afro puff. I mean, she's nice, but she might play it, but she. No, really. And as we continue through the pageant, which was about a month of preparation, everywhere we go, people would say, God, they're nice, it's a pity. The judges love the detail. Eventually, we would go to beaches, Oscar Bell. That was the hotel that hosted us for a week. And they had a public boat competition. And I ended up winning talent and I won public boat. These were white people, you know, foreigners, and everybody voting for who they thought best represented Jamaica. And I remember playmakers coming to me and saying, yeah, you're good enough. You're not. And it was the same. They thought I would have been wrong. So for a month, I literally had people asking me, so what are you going to do with your hair? What are you going to do with your hair? And the night before the pageant, you have a consultation with your hair sponsors. You can cut, color, cream, curl, you can do anything that you want to do with your hair to really prepare your hair for the competition the following day. They saved me for last. We had a long table discussion and we looked at me and I said, so what are you going to do with your hair? And I said, we're going to wash it, we're going to condition it, and we're going to keep it moving. We went on the night, I won. It was fantastic because I had to maintain who I was.
Oh, yeah.
What mattered to me wasn't the win or the lose, the loss, but the fact of the matter is that when you see me today, when you see me tomorrow, I will be the very same Terri-Karelle, and I am not changing to satisfy you, because you are the very same person after I cream my hair. You can come and tell me, so I don't cut it. Then there's another way to do it. And then you cut it. And then you're the same person who's going to come to you and say, I think I should put in the weave. And then I got put in the weave, and you tell me, say, you know, I like it, you're blue. And then when I put in the blue, and I do all the things I asked for, you know what you're going to tell me? You know, I prefer you with your natural hair. I am not here to please you. Whatever you want to do with your hair, and your body, and your skin tone, you do it. But you're not going to impose it on me. So I went to China. People then say, well, you know, you get your own natural hair in Jamaica, and a local thing, a local product, and a local product, you don't know. And you go to China with all the Jamaica, you go say, you can't wear your natural hair. And of course, we went for like a month, and then they asked people in chat rooms, the interviewers, everybody asked, so, what are you going to do with your hair for the final night? And I said, I'm going to wash it. For those of you who may not know, I came second in talent for dance. I placed in Beach Beauty. I was one of the most photographed contestants, especially on AsianBeauties.com. And I couldn't figure it out because I don't look Asian. And yesterday when they asked the photographer, I want you to take a picture of the girl with the afro, he said, she's a
of course.
So if you want 120 girls and all of them come with the long ones, and all of them come with the straight ones, and all of them come with, and then you have all the natural afro, nothing does for you that it differentiates you. Why blame me when you can stand out? So you can't only be. So you can't only imagine, you know, I'm with this black group and she's almost sheep, so sheep I'm going to win at first point. And I'm like, you know, good luck, you know. They don't really expect much because they don't know what these pageants are about. And then when they call me first for the Caribbean, and I see my Jamaican flags flying on either side, you cannot understand the pride, because I'm saying to myself, first of all, anyone watching, you know that that's Jamaica, right? Get used to the colors. But if you say more normies, everybody know the colors, but that's my country. Secondly, this is me, and I did not change yet. I am not changing now. So you need to ask yourself, and you need to figure it out very quickly, who are you? When you figure that out, everybody can't come and batter you. And you do everything, because at the end of the day, you will not please everyone. You must be able to filter, accept constructive criticism. You must know when sound advice comes, but you must be able to decipher who is here to give you constructive criticism and who is here to take you for a joyride. Figure out who you are. To my youth members, who wants to be engineers, chauffeurs, engineers, doctors, lawyers, nurses, cosmetologists, police officers, probably no, architects,
teachers,
soldiers. Am I leaving on any career?
Psychologist.
And psychology, we have a lot of crazy people. Why do I ask that question? You've now figured out who you are. It is good to know that our youth know where they want to go. Is it okay to change your mind along your path? Absolutely.
Yes.
There's some of us who say we want to be doctors in third form, and by the time we get to third form, we start to be TVs or what? I think we want to be an engineer. There's nothing wrong with that. So it's really good to know that when you ask them, they can at least say, this is my goal for now. It means that you have a target. If you don't have a target, and you don't have a goal, then you are like a ship that sets sail without a
destination.
I don't know about you, but I would like that if I got on a ship or a plane, the captain, the pilot, was able to tell me, we will be arriving at so-and-so by so-and-so time. If you can't tell me that, why am I on your plane? Why am I on your train? And why am I on your boat? So you don't know where it is you are going. That is fantastic. You can change your mind, but don't be indecisive. What do I mean? I studied veterinary medicine in Cuba, got a government scholarship. One of two Jamaicans who were able to get that particular scholarship. And when we got there, there was a girl from St. Lucia who was already a year ahead of us. Watch the ride. We passed through our first year and we catch up and she repeated the year. Okay, she changed her mind, she changed her career, no problem. I passed my year and I went forward and she was still there because she changed her
again
mind.